Ishvara Sarva Bhutanam Pradeshe Arjuna Tishthati Brahmayan Sarva Bhutani Yantra Rudhani Mahaya. Ishvara 18.61 Bhagavad Gita. Ishvara Sarva Bhutanam. The Lord of all living entities, Riddeshe, in the region of the heart, Arjuna Tishtati. O Arjuna, that Ishvara resides in the region of the heart. Brahmayan Sarva Bhutani. And from there, what does he do? Brahmayan. He causes to wander or directs the wandering. Sarva Bhutani, all living beings. Yantra Rudhani Mayaya. The living beings, how does he cause them to wander? Because those living beings are situated on a yantra, on a machine, which is comprised of Maya, which is made of material nature. And he is the Ishvara of not just the living entities, he is the Ishvara of nature also. And that's how he controls and he guides the wandering of all living beings. Now, the key to understand this verse is to recognize divine, the relationship between divine direction and human discretion. Discretion here in this context refers to our capacity to choose what we would like to do. Now, Krishna guides us according to what we desire. So, Brahmayan, when he calls us to wander, that does not mean that it is he who takes away our free will and makes us wander. Rather, when we desire to wander, when we desire towards one sense object or other sense object, in the hope of pleasure, then Krishna guides us accordingly so that we can seek that sense object. So, actually speaking, we as souls have nothing to do with matter. So, we won't even know how to approach, how to operate a material body and how to connect the senses of one material body with the sense objects and then get and seek some pleasure through that. All that knowledge comes through Krishna, through his presence as a super soul in the heart. Now, when we chant the holy names, we are actually praying to Krishna to give us guidance to engage in his service. We recognize that Krishna, I am your servant. I am meant to serve you eternally. And the way I can serve you is by dovetailing whatever nature I have at a bodily mental level in your service. So that's why this verse says that actually we wander on the machine of Maya. But within the framework, within the context of the machine of Maya that we have, we can still surrender. And that's why the next verse will say, Tameva Sharanam Gacha Sarva Bhavena Bharata Tat Prasadat Param Shantim Sthanam Prapsisi Shashvatam Tam Eva Sharanam Gacha. Surrender unto that Supreme Lord, that Ishvara. And by that, one will attain the supreme destination, the supreme peace and the supreme destination. So, when we are trying to chant the holy names, and when we find our mind not seeking rest in Krishna, but rather seeking stimulation in worldly objects, then we can pray to Krishna. Krishna, you are the controller of material nature. You are the controller even of the mind. I am trying to control according to my capacity, but ultimately I can't. As an expression of my devotion to you, as an expression of my determination to try to carry out your instruction, I will keep trying to control my mind. But please, Krishna, I want to serve you. And I want to serve you by absorbing my consciousness in you. So please, let my heart find rest in you. Iti mati upakalpita vitrishana, as Bhishma says on the last day of his life, let me absorb my consciousness in you. Similarly, my dear Lord, I desire that let my consciousness get absorbed in you. And when we acknowledge Krishna's supreme controllership, and when we utilize our finite controllership in the service of the infinite control of the supreme controllership of the infinite one, then the magnitude of our controllership expands. Paradoxically, isn't it? That actually, as long as we think we are the controllers of the world, we can't control even our own mind. But once we acknowledge Krishna, as the controller of the world and harmonize our limited controllership with Him. That means, Krishna, whatever resources I have, whatever abilities I have, I will use that to do your will. I will use that to serve you. Then, actually, we become focused. Our capacity to control expands, because that disposition to serve takes away much of the passion of the mind. It de-energizes the mind, and thereby, and actually this happens not just by our endeavor, but also Krishna's mercy. Krishna becomes pleased, and He uses His omnipotence to control our mind. And that's how we become free from the deadly delusions that bind all living beings in this world. That's how we move onwards towards Krishna through the practice of fixing our consciousness on Him. Thank you.